Hey, everybody. My name is Greg Gordon, and it is my unique pleasure to introduce my friends, Brooke Moser, Haylee Ryan, Yale.
I'm Brooke Moser.
What do you do? I'm an interior designer.
And I create beautiful spaces, and I connect beautiful people.
Ayo.
Awesome. Haylee.
And I'm Haylee Ryan, Yale. Mm-hmm. I'm a painter, a visual artist, and I paint beautiful people. Now, I love to tell stories and make memories and keep memories alive through my work and meeting and knowing new people.
And how did you know Haylee?
And so I had a vision of this lobby being a story or something big and bold. And I had followed Haylee on Instagram because we, in our neighborhood, there's a giant, beautiful mural on the side of a building that I've just been in love with. And so murals have their little handle down below at Haylee Ryan.
Right.
I mean, it was just like, these people need to be connected because you're so thoughtful and stories mean so much to you. And that means so much to you too. So it was like perfect marriage of an idea.
You are a networker.
Yeah, I am.
It wasn't until our phone call where you started telling me the story and we started connecting about memory and nostalgia and storytelling that I was like, oh boy, this is really meaningful.
Right.
And then I remember shortly after that realizing this shouldn't be a mural. This should be something that you guys have forever, that right. you can carry with you till the end of time.
The other thing that I remember that was hard for me is you said, I need people's faces. Mm-hmm. I can't make the feelings come to life without real characters in there. Mm-hmm. So we had the colors and we knew the setting, right? Mm-hmm. And we knew some of the characters, right? But you were like, hey, who are the people that mean the most to you?
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, and they're in there. And it's even when I, because I work from my home, so I have a studio in my home, but actually the painting was too large to fit in my studio, so I painted it in my living room. Mm-hmm. And it was during the pandemic, so not many people were coming by, but you know, if I was FaceTiming with someone or if someone did come by, they're like, what in the world are you making? And then I found myself telling a story, and it wasn't, and I don't like to do this, it wasn't arbitrary faces. I was like, this is Greg Gordon's grandfather. He was the first immigrant that came to America. People were like, what? You know, and so even the fact, and you know that the woman in the yellow swimsuit, I believe.
We put Noonie, my grandmother, and she's in there in a two-piece and she's rolling over in her grave.
She loves it.
She looks perfect.
Yes.
And I pushed for her.
And just the fact, it was just an odd like thing to put in, but it just makes it.
A lot of my work, it feels like a collage, like things have been cut out and placed together. There's realistic with abstract there, you know, but I think that's because that's kind of how our stories are. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like a little piece from here and a piece from here and this person mm-hmm. and this color stuck in my mind. I don't know why, because it made me feel this way. This landscape's in the background. Mm-hmm. And so although this is about, I don't know, maybe 8 to 10 different subject matters that I've placed together, it makes a pretty cohesive story that's easy to tell.
Wow.
No, she's I'm pretty blown amazing, away. Right?
Well, do you want to tell them about the Duchess?
The Duchess of Gordon was the person who actually did start the Gordon Highlander Regiment.
That's it.
Because they didn't have enough people in the military, and it wasn't like obviously a popular thing. The boys didn't want to come. They asked the Duke if he would start another regiment, and she said, I bet I can get more to join than the government. And so she went around in her black full getup for the regiment, and she would give them a king's shilling ? And a kiss. And she, I think, got somewhere around 950 men to join, and they were the Gordon Highlanders.
Nailed it.
Wow.
Call me Wiki. Wikipedia.
She should just stand here every morning. She should stand here every morning and tell the story.
She just nailed it.
Yeah. I'd do it for the right price. And I know that the color scheme Brooke kind of gave me from the interiors, which was beautiful and so unique and moody, which is perfect for like Scotland and the Scottish Highlands. Mm-hmm. And then I know that you had mentioned different symbols from the story, like the, oh boy, I was about to say stag.
It is a stag.
Yes.
Yes!
Most people don't know that.
What is the symbolism of that?
The stag represents stamina and strength. One of our core values is steadfast, and we define our values. So we don't use other people's words. We use our own, and it means to never give up, to stand and fight.
The men that are coming down the middle, I actually took them from the cover of a book that is a like a concise history of the Gordon Highlanders. Mm. Guess what it's called?
The Gordon Highlanders.
That's correct. I believe by Thomas Royce. And then the background is a painted, painterly version of a Scottish Highland landscape. Mm. So there it all is.
And I wasn't here the day that you hung it.
But tell us about when you saw it for the first time.
So when I saw it for the first time, I don't know, did I call you?
No, you were silent. Mm. That's what we were like, did you like it?
Because really?
We were
both nice, Greg. Seriously. Nice.
I know.
But this, you're making up to us now.
Oh, please. Sometimes I do move that piece on the chessboard like two down. And so like right away, I was like, dude, I can't wait to show my parents.
Oh, that's so cool.
Oh, man, I was scheming on how to get them to the office without them knowing why. And I wanted to bless them and show them what you did.
What you did.
I mean, it's very moving, obviously. It's just, I think we probably all feel like very blessed and fortunate to be doing something in our lives that can really move people and create memories and experiences.
Mm-hmm. That's what it's all about, right?
Mm-hmm. And so to see you... to see you get, you know, moved by something that I got to be a part of is, it's really special. So.
No.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Brooke!
Like you mentioned, hopefully this painting goes into eternity, right? What a powerful thought. What is someone gonna, what is my grandkid gonna experience when he sees it? Mm. It's that's why we did it. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not exactly sure what the feeling is, but I know that what you're talking about is how to bring that feeling out. And so I want everyone to know that there's an amazing story behind me. And I believe there's an amazing one in front of me.